An Autumn California Dreaming. An interesting comedy. Comedy drama, really, because there's some tragic incidents as well in it. Not on a par with 4 months, 3 weeks, 2 days. Christian Bale, of course. Moartea Domnului Lazarescu, the death of Mr. Lazarescu, and some other powerful Romanian works. Chef d'oeuvre, some of them, indeed. Bacalaureate. But still interesting. It has an ironic, tragic twist in real life too. Christian Mescu, the director of this good film, announcing a good career, if not outstanding, maybe, we never know. He was so young and he was killed by an American in an accident, but still an idiot, part of the Marine Defense, whatever unit here at the embassy, was driving like a stupid lunatic, and he banged the taxi in which this director was so hard that he killed this artist. Well, rest in peace. So. Yes. We have Armand Lassante as an American captain, Doc Jones, Răzvan Vasilescu, one of our best actors, present in all sorts of films. I've seen him in Gainsbourg recently as a piano teacher. He's Doianu, station master. And the funny premise, challenging indeed, is that this station master working in a field in the middle of nowhere in Romania stops a NATO train. In a way, exaggerating, of course, this looks like the Chinese student who stands in front of the column of advancing Chinese tanks, which were anyway going to kill so many in Tiananmen Square. China being a barbaric communist regime, otherwise, one would tend to forget that. I say that because I've been in a communist regime, so I know what it is for those who love socialist ideas. And it's they haven't lived it. It sounds like a good place to be. Anyway, so this station master says papers or documents. If you don't have the proper documents, customs, whatever, you don't pass. It's the law, and so he sticks with it, and it's also David versus Goliath, right? In a way. And it all descends into a sort of a parody, in a way, Naked Gun and so on. And guy who just can do anything, including stopping this convoy. There's pressure, they send the second in command at the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and so on. And he wants, give me an official, so that, not what. They try and threaten him. Even locally, the mayor of the town is much against this guy, Doianu. He's the evil, he's the devil, he has to suffer. Maybe he will, I'm not sure what happens at the end. There's musique populaire, there's folk music, the love affairs between the Marines, the American soldiers, and the local girls. There's added local flavor. There's some horrific passages, probably meant to be, but I must say I didn't like that. They have a Dracula horror show just to point out maybe and laugh the fact that we are so much associated with this, and sometimes we play in the hands of visitors. I don't know. I was in the hospitality business and I was doing Dracula tours, so in a way I benefited from this. If they come and want to see that, why not? I mean, there it is. There's a union strike, there's some political implications, local facts. As I said, they put this horrible show. Horrible not in the sense that it's so kitschy and disgusting. There's some Romanian local thugs talking slang, dirty F word so much and so on. And there's also a love story that develops between the translator, the girl who is trying to date an American soldier, but only the translator being in love with a girl is saying all the wrong things. Like the soldier, the American, wants to be with her, but he doesn't say that. The girl is interested, but he just says to the American, she doesn't like company. So he takes advantage of this, and it is a little funny. Otherwise, the film didn't really take me aback. It's just 6, 7, I don't know, on a scale from 1 to 10.